Welcome back to the third part of What's New in Autodesk Inventor 2017, a deep dive into new functionality. This is Andreas Amstwagner and I'm working as a designated support specialist at Autodesk. In Inventor 2016, we've extended the multi-body part environment to support sheet metal parts and introduced the support for zero bend radius for certain commands. With Inventor 2017, we continue to improve the sheet metal environment. Enjoy the new functionality. If you often use sheet metal eye features, you will recognize the new flat pattern punch representations drop-down list in the punch tool dialog box. You can now create individual punch representations for each stamping shape in the flat pattern environment. Compared to Inventor 2016, the punch representation settings are controlled by the sheet metal rules in the style and standard editor and get applied to all inserted eye features. Additionally, the Ignore Flat Pattern Overrides is added as an option to the Punch Representation tab of the Edit Flat Pattern Definition dialog. If the option is active, all punch representations are controlled by the Punch Representation setting of the Flat Pattern Edit dialog box. If the option Ignore Flat Pattern Overrides is inactive, the individual settings of the new Flat Pattern Punch Representations drop-down list in the Punch Tool dialog box take precedence. I think this video provides an additional explanation about the new behavior. The sheet metal part shall be equipped with a punch based on a sheet metal eye feature. The eye feature itself I have already prepared and start the use of Punch Tool command. I shortly demonstrate the new Flat Pattern Punch Representations drop-down list in the Punch Tool dialog box and apply the punch placement. Please note that I've selected the 2D sketch wrap and center mark. In the next step, I create a flat pattern and go into the Edit Flat Pattern Definition command. Let's focus on the new Ignore Flat Pattern Overrides option now. You can see the option is active and overrides the representation setting of the punch eye feature. So the formed punch feature is visible instead of the 2D sketch representation. I uncheck the option now and the representation setting of the punch eye feature is used. Let's shortly switch back to the folded model. I'm going to change the eye feature representation setting to 2D sketch representation. The Ignore Flat Pattern Overrides option is still inactive and the folded model is displaying the setting of the eye feature representation. Something is good to know are the three additional corner relief types, round tangent, round vertex, and square vertex, have been added in Inventor 2017. Extremely useful is the small information icon gets displayed now if a flat pattern has compute errors. Besides the information, you can use the Design Doctor to troubleshoot compute errors. Another very nice option has been added to the Extract Eye feature and Punch Tool Insert dialog boxes. Previously, Inventor didn't support to unfold sheet metal eye features. Now you can specify the unfold capability during the eye feature creation by simply using the Unfold in Flat Pattern checkbox. But please, be aware of you need to activate the checkbox in the Extract Eye feature and Punch Tool dialog to unfold the punch shape. Further, unfolding is limited to eye features that can be unfolded if they were created as normal sheet metal features. I'm quickly creating a user-defined sheet metal eye feature, shall be able to be unfolded. I need to enable the Unfold in Flat Pattern checkbox to benefit from the unfold capability. Just an aside during I save the file. If you start to create eye features, use always an independent part for this creation, please. In case there is a geometric mismatch inside the eye feature after it's been created, the issue appears as soon as you use the eye feature in a different part than the part you extracted it. So you follow the guideline, that an eye feature should be insertable in each part that meets the geometric requirements for a specific eye feature. I also switched to another port to insert my created eye feature. As you may know, to place eye features, a sketch point on a surface or plane is the only requirement eye features ideally need. In the next step, I insert the eye feature and make sure this checkbox Unfold in Flat Pattern is disabled to show you the difference. Entering the flat pattern environment, we get a model with an unfolded eye feature as expected. I quickly switch back to the folded model and enable the Unfold in Flat Pattern checkbox in the eye feature itself. Accessing the flat pattern environment again, you can now see the used eye feature is unfolded. So, something easy to digest. There is now an apply button in the corner round and corner chamfer dialog boxes. Also, the corner round dialog box is resizable and persists throughout an inventor session. As soon as you have a more complex sheet metal model, the time for computing the flat pattern can increase. Then you can use the defer update option to prevent the automatic update of the unfolded model. You have now in the document settings, in the file open options, and in the browser context menu, defer update options available.